Hi, and welcome to Farenheit AI episode 22. Today we're going to look at the AI manager agent that actually made a funny joke. We're going to look at AI art disclosures and the current state of AI and the jam band scene. So last week, AI made the news in the jam band scene. Tedeschi Trucks had a show at Red Rocks, and they released a statement that their fan community brought to their attention that the artwork generated for the Red Rocks show poster was AI generated, in the fan base opinion. So they asked the artist for files outlining their creative process. They apologized to their fan base, and they donated all of the proceeds from the Red Rocks show to the Access Gallery. The artist, known as Brilliant Workshop on Instagram, only has 3 posts. This is one of the reasons the fanbase suspected that it was AI-generated, and possibly even an AI bot. Since this controversy, the artist has posted a video showing their work, but they have admitted that it is AI-generated.
Now the comedy is over, the tragedy is done.
The artist goes on to offer a long explanation about how they pieced it together. While AI art is something that is very controversial, they say, excluding it entirely is to cut off a new tool, a new useful aspect that an artist can use. The artist defended the reason they have 3 posts is because this is a new business. They've previously worked for major brands like VF, and they were really excited to get into poster making for the Trucks Tedeschi show at Red Rocks. One of the ways that you can mitigate this issue, what I've started doing with my comps, is AI disclosures. If anything in my design touches AI in any form, I disclose what it is with an image or a reference and describe exactly what was related to AI. So if anything in my design touches AI in any form, I disclose what it is. I use an image or a reference and describe exactly what was related to AI. For example, there are things like modified and redrawn from AI reference, AI inspiration elements, or actual AI elements. AI references showing the font that was referenced but not used, or AI pure inspiration. If it's a fully generated image, I disclose that. The AI manager agent. This is a new type of agent that we've started building that oversees other agents. So you have a main agent that is connected to all these other worker agents. It's given a description on how to choose which agent to use. I'm still working through that. Right now, it's given logic statements, if this, then that kind of choice, and it chooses, in this case, between 5 worker agents that perform tasks. It provides a set of instructions for those worker agents to perform their task. The agents have their own instructions that you can see as I'm cycling through them. The manager agent will modify any of those instructions based on the query by the user. Let's take a look at this in action. Right now, it's set up to answer questions about recipes and food. In the future, it will be translated to screen printing aspects for our shops. One of the reasons I start with food is because it has a huge database. That way, it makes it easier for me to do testing against the agent. When I move into screen printing or some other smaller database, it's easier to identify where the problems are coming from, because most of the bugs will have been worked out already. In this case, I'm asking how to make a soufflé. I'm saying I would like the technical direction. I'm also able to upload an image, which is optional, but I'm going to give it a picture of a soufflé. I'm going to check in the debugger on how it's performing as it's running through its steps. The first step goes to the manager agent, and the manager evaluates the image, evaluates the question, and decides which agent is the proper agent to answer this task. As it goes through the image analysis, it identifies that it's a chocolate souffle that is very well baked. Then the manager agent assigns it to a task agent, which is the recipe finder, and it gives me a recipe. But that's not exactly what I was looking for, and I'm not sure why it doesn't want to use the technical agent to answer my question. The answer that it gives me is very technical, and it did a good job answering, it just assigned it to the wrong agent. So let me try again. I'm going to ask, what is the most challenging part of making a souffle technically? And again, ask for the technical agent, and again, load in the image. Checking the debugger, I see that it's basically performing the exact same image analysis, so that's good, it's not changing its answer. And the manager agent is reviewing the request. Again, it's assigning the task to the recipe finder, which is not what I was looking for. The answer it gives is good, but it's not the technical agent. So I need to try again. I need to change something beyond just the wording. How to bake a souffle. How to bake a perfect souffle. I'm looking for technical instruction. I'm going to load my image. This time I used a new version of the manager agent that was updated. Basically, I said if someone asks how to, that is a technical question, so give it to the technical agent. And it does. A lot of the response is the same, but it reassigned it to the technical agent. And the technical agent is instructed to give me some video options. In reviewing the answer, it's not giving me a recipe, it's giving me technical guidance on how to bake a souffle properly. What can go wrong, what you need to pay attention to, what are the most important steps? If you could imagine this scenario against screen printing puff, for example, it could be very similar in its response. It tells me to prepare the souffle dish, to make the base, to whip the egg whites, to fold the whites into the base, to fill and bake, and to serve immediately. The key for successful souffle is properly whipping the egg whites and gently folding them into the base. With the right technique, you can create a light, airy, and impressive souffle at home. I asked for it to give me some video links that show technical answers to the questions as well, and it does. It gives me links to America's Test Kitchen, Bon Appetit, and Epicurious as well. Let's click on the video and make sure the links are active. The first video link takes me to a video called The Epic Split. Very funny, AI. This has nothing to do with souffles, but souffles can split. If you've never seen this video before, enjoy. It's amazing.
I've had my ups and downs. My fair share of bumpy roads and heavy winds. That's what made me what I am today. Now I stand here before you. What you see is a body crafted to perfection. A pair of legs engineered to defy the laws of physics. And a mindset to master the most epic of splits.
The irony of this video is that Jean-Claude Van Damme is doing a split between these two trucks as they drive backwards on this closed-loop raceway. With AI-generated videos and deepfakes, this can be created easily without him ever having to do that. So that begs the question, will anything like this ever exist again? And if it does, can it be believed? And as an artist, are we the new race car driver on the closed loop track because we have to put out disclosures and show our work? Like our math teacher always said.
Thanks so much, you guys.